Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. With no standard SpaceX news, we are heading straight to Boca Chica as work continues on the orbital launch mount. Work also continues on the yellow structure at the launch site, which is now known to be the quick disconnect arm. DOS from NASA Spaceflight posted a video of the Starship stacking with the caption, "Previously at the spaceport that doesn't exist." Musk responded with, "Soon Mechazilla will have arms." There was a tweet posted with a video of how it could look when Mechazilla catches a Super Heavy and puts it back on the launch mount. Musk responded with, "Pretty close. Booster and arms will move faster. Quick disconnect arm will steady booster for ship mate." He also posted another tweet in response to that with, "And ship will be caught by Mechazilla too. As with booster, no landing legs. Those are only needed for Moon and Mars until there is local infrastructure." Musk was then asked, "So Mars will eventually get its own Mechazilla. Would there be any value in eventually building Super Heavy boosters on Mars as a launch platform for outer solar system missions?" He responded with, "Yes on both counts. That would be a great outcome for civilization." There was a thread of the steps SpaceX takes to build their rockets. Musk responded with, "Actual volume manufacturing where cash in is more than cash out is so hard most people have no idea." Somebody then asked Musk, "When will Starship production become cost effective? Booster 20? Booster 200? He responded and said, "Starship will be crushingly cost-effective for Earth orbit or moon missions as soon as it's operational and rapid reuse is happening. Mars is a lot harder because Earth and Mars only align every 26 months, so ship reuse is limited to approximately a dozen times over 25 to 30 year life of ship. Work continues on this new structure near the production site, which is a booster thrust simulator. There's also another new structure being constructed in Boca Chica." Michael Sheets posted a tweet about SpaceX receiving its first payment under the Human Landing System contract. It says, "NASA paid $300 million to SpaceX, its most recent major payment under the HLS program towards Starship on July 30th, the day the GAO denied the protests of Blue Origin and Dynetics." There was another tweet about this with a question to Elon Musk on the Starship lunar variant. It says, "NASA has started its SpaceX lunar lander payments. Hopefully and I trust the SpaceX team will work fast. Elon Musk, do you expect to have lunar Starship ready to land humans in 2024 despite other delays?" Musk responded with, "Probably sooner." There was a tweet posted with a picture captioned "History and Future" all in one image. Starship really has come a long way. Musk responded and said, "We are working on enabling public access to our restaurant." Last week, we saw a tweet from Musk in response to the HLS protest from Blue Origin about 16 flights being unlikely. He also posted another response to his tweet with, "Note, should be refill, not refuel. Approximately 78% of propellant is liquid oxygen, only approximately 22% is fuel." Marcus House posted a tweet saying, "Starship hauling approximately 150 tons to low Earth orbit for a tiny fraction of cost compared to now will change everything. People really don't get it yet. As soon as SpaceX reaches low Earth orbit with full reuse alone, the game has changed." Musk responded with, "Starship will enable humanity to become a multi-planet species." The ground support equipment tank GSE-6 was recently rolled out and hooked up to a crane. Work was continuing during the week on Starship 20's thermal protection system. On Friday, the Starship 20 prototype was rolled back out to the launch site. Here's a view of the Ship 21 aft dome hanging out in a production tent. The Super Heavy booster-free prototype was cut in half to be scrapped. Earlier in the week, the Super Heavy Booster 4 prototype was rolled back to the production site. Loads of Raptor engines were also removed from Booster 4. I want to take a look at the road and beach closures currently posted on the Cameron County website. You can see there is a road closure only which is scheduled for tomorrow, I want to say possibly for Booster 4 rollout since Ship 20 was rolled out during the week. Then there is a primary road and beach closure posted for Wednesday 18th with a backup closure on Thursday and Friday should they need more time. So, I think as soon as Wednesday we could see the first testing take place with the Starship 20 prototype, very exciting. Cosmic Perspective posted a really cool slow-mo video of the Booster 4 prototype rolling back to the production site. Musk responded and said, "Booster and ship will return to orbital launch pad on Monday, winds allowing. Just finishing off some small plumbing and wiring, which is easier in the high bay." Musk has also provided more info on when we can hopefully expect the first orbital flight. Teslarati posted a tweet about an article which says, "Looking back at Starship SN8 and thinking how much progress SpaceX has made on Starbase. Orbital pad nearly complete, testing of a Super Heavy booster and SN20 happening soon, very exciting to watch history be made at such a rapid pace." Musk responded with, "First orbital stack of Starship should be ready for flight in a few weeks pending only regulatory approval." He was then asked, "Is that a few weeks in Elon time or real time?" Musk responded and said, "Real time." Finally, for our Sunday video, as always, we have the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. Of course, the very final thing for this video, I have to say thanks to Mary or Boca Chica girl who is constantly out in Boca Chica filming. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.